everyone, welcome to Morning English. This is Nora.
Hello, everybody. This is Summer. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。So, Nora, have you ever done anything to support your idol?
为我的偶像应援吗？
对啊。
我做的最多的应该就是看他们的节目，然后在心里默默地打 call.
That's it? Then maybe you can be called a super fan.
Yeah, I know. Usually fans do a lot of things to support their idols, ranging from buying a lot of gifts, sending letters, to standing in line for hours just to catch a glimpse of their idols.
是的。前面说到的 support an idol 意思就是为某个偶像来应援打 call、然后呢粉丝的应援活动啊通常就是有很多种对吧
对
有买礼物啊送信啊还有机场接机啊像你这样子佛系粉丝挺少的了
Yeah, probably. Talking of which, do you know that 何炅、a renowned TV host has been under fire recently?
对听说了 be under fire这个表达呢本意就是说在战火的攻击下、那么它引申出来就可以指 someone is being criticized strongly 就是一个人被饱受批评或者攻击
对
所以就是说何炅啊大家都认识他嘛对吧他最近被挖出来就收了很多粉丝的应援礼物那因为这件事呢被网友们抨击了
Right 那我们今天呢就一起来聊一聊娱乐圈收礼的这件事儿
今天呢给大家送个超棒的福利早安英文会员课程的七天免费体验权限只有十个名额哦。同时呢大家也可以加入早安英文的 Telegram 社群来群里和我们一起交流。社群地址和七天会员的免费领取链接都放在评论区了欢迎你来。
So first, I have to clarify one thing. The majority of those gifts actually are not from his fans.
Yeah.Most of the gifts were sent by the fan groups of celebrities who had been invited to appear on Happy Camp.
对，那送礼的其实一般并不是何老师他自己的粉丝，而是通常都是要上快乐大本营嘉宾的粉丝。
Happy Camp. I guess they're doing this so that their idols would have a better relationship with program staff.
Exactly.他们这样做啊，其实除了说对于偶像的爱，更多的是因为一种心理，就是送了礼嘛，偶像就能够受到优待。
Yeah, and more importantly, those fans are usually juveniles who can't even earn money by their own.
Right, 那很多粉丝后援会啊，他们都是年轻的群体，还有很多未成年人 juveniles, 那他们都没有赚钱能力。那就是父母的血汗钱了 But they're actually sending luxury items Something even like golden bars It's really terrifying
对感觉这已经成为娱乐圈的一种潜规则就不止何炅啊快乐大本营的主持人呢其实很多这样的电视节目多多少少应该有类似的现象
Yeah, sending gifts to TV hosts has already become an unspoken rule That fans should obey in the entertainment industry
Yeah,An unspoken rule, it means a rule that is understood, but does not exist in written form. 就是中文所说的潜规则。
Right. 那说到潜规则啊，其实刚出来这个词的时候呢，另外一个翻译也非常的流行，就是 hidden rules. Hidden 正好就是指的隐藏的意思嘛，所以 hidden rules, 潜规则，就听上去非常的简单又直白。
对，很清晰。But we should also be careful that in English, the expression hidden rules does not necessarily suggest impropriety.
Yeah, impropriety, 意思就是不得体。那中文我们说潜规则嘛，其实大部分都是说不好的、负面
的
事情。但是在说 hidden rules 和前面的 unspoken rules 这两个表达的时候呢，就是泛指的隐藏的社会规则，比如说这种公众场合不要大声说话呀，这种就不一定是负面的一些新闻。
哎，对。但是呢，有一种比较负面的潜规则呢，就是 you know, which is called casting couch.
Casting couch.这个表达呢就非常形象了。It specifically refers to couches in offices that could be used for sexual activity between casting directors and aspiring actors.
Right. Casting 就是指电影里的选角。所以呢这种 casting directors 指的就是星探或者是选角导演对吧然后呢另外一个词 couch 就是沙发。所以大家可以想想哦，这种沙发就是专门为选角导演和那些想要成为演员的明星来准备的。
那大家应该可以意会这个潜规则到底指的是什么了。
Yeah.
So casting couch, at least in the past years, was very much a part of the culture in film industry.
And maybe still.
Exactly.
好，那我们回到刚刚前面说到的关于送礼这件事啊，那后面何炅他本人是怎么回应的呢？
Well, he wrote on Weibo that he was very sorry that he didn't refuse the gifts in some situations, and he will take this opportunity to explicitly decline all gifts in the future.
Refuse or decline gifts, 意思就是拒绝收礼。所以他就是通过这件事情呢，先是道个歉，然后呢，明确以后呢，就再也不收礼物了。
Yeah, but the netizens' opinions seem to diverge greatly on this issue.
Diverge, 意思就是分歧。So diverge greatly on this issue, 就是说在这件事情上呢，分歧很大。So what did they say?
Well, his fans are arguing that何炅 has publicly clarified that he wouldn't accept gifts and asked his fans not sending them several times.
就是一部分人相信何炅的为人和清白。
嗯，
就之前有节目记录呢，可以看到他确实是公开劝说过他的粉丝啊，就是不要送礼。然后呢，他也会对他们喜欢的艺人好。
对 ，while others were saying he still took it anyway, and if he worked in government system, he would have been fired for taking those gifts.
确实。如果这是在政府机构呢，其实应该算贿赂了，对吧 ？Bribery，
对 ，bribery 就是贿赂的名词啊，动词就是 bribe。
Right. So in general, bribery is an attempt to make someone do something for you by giving the person money, presents, or something else that they want.
是的，就是通过金钱啊，还有其他想要的物品呢，去贿赂他人。
对。
那通常这个接受贿赂的人还会承诺帮你做一定的事情。
但是何炅这件事情其实算不上贿赂，对吧？
嗯，
不过还是希望演艺圈以后这种行为呢，能够通过这件事情呢都被制止。
Yeah, but actually sending gifts is not just common in the entertainment business. It is in fact prevalent in many areas.
Right, such as at work. 就比如工作的时候就会有这种现象，就是送礼呀、走后门啊，用关系找工作。
Yeah, and that's called pulling the strings in English.
Strings, 意思就是绳子 pulling the strings, 字面意思是拉这个绳子。
对。
其实实际指的就是 make use of one's influence and contacts to gain an advantage unofficially or unfairly.
对，那这个短语呢，来源其实是木偶戏啊，大家知道其实木偶都是通过这种 strings,
绳子
来操控的嘛。所以用这个短语就可以表达幕后操控，然后通过找关系啊，走后门。
Right. Using this kind of way to succeed is like cheating, right? Taking the shortcut.
没错，就不管是送礼还是动用关系嘛，就感觉都是 taking the shortcut.
对，走捷径，
就是走捷径了，都是投机取巧的行为。
没错，还是专业能力过硬呢，最重要。
Right.
好了，那今天节目呢，就到这里了。
That's all for today's podcast. This is Nora. Thanks for listening.
This is Summer. See you next time.
Bye.
今天的节目就到这里了，大家别忘了去评论区领取我们的福利，早安英文会员课程的7天免费试听名额，只有10个，先到先得。最后，大家如果想加入我们的听众群，也可以在评论区置顶找到我们的 Telegram 社群地址，欢迎你来玩。
This podcast is from Morning English.
学口语就来早安英文。